Welcome to online classes, students. So today in our class we are going to learn a new chapter, which is plants and their leaves. So this is chapter 8 and this is the part of assessment 2. Hope you all are safe at your home. So let's start the chapter. So firstly, I will give you example of human body. When we birth as a baby, right? When we grow as a child. Then we grow above, we grow as adult, right? As a teenager, or then adult to a old man, to a middle aged man. So this is our growth, right? So in the plants, this is the movement of their development. So today we are going to learn about, we can open your 57 page number just like me. Please take your pencil also and make underline of important things you can see in your chapter, like about various types of plants, about various uses of plant, the importance in our life of plants, right? The special trees, the about leaves, structures, about using of leaves. So many topics are here, but we will only take some topics and we will take a huge explanation about it and we will discuss it. If you're having any problem, if you want to share any your thoughts, you can comment in your classroom. Okay, students, be active in your classroom because this is the only platform where you can speak and you can share your problems, right? And we are here to resolve your problems. Hope you are understanding my point. Okay, so let's do this. In the starting point, some pictures are given to us, but before we do this, we have to learn our chapter, which means we have to read our chapter very carefully. So students, hope you will read it very carefully. Start reading with me, because reading is very must for you. If you want to learn English better and want to speak better, that means you have to read it first, right? Any word, you have to read it. So let's start the about plants. So plants have an essential role in the life of every living being, right? The essential, you can underline it, and that is means important, which means important role in our life. Why? In our daily life, we are using vegetables, we are using plants, we are using roses. So these all are kind of, you know, plant. Nowadays in the summer, we are eating mangoes. That is the part of our tree, right? So these are using in our daily life. So that's why it is written here that they play a important role in our life, right? Mm-hmm. There are numerous plant in the world, which means there are numbers of, matlab, like a big quantity of plants and varieties of plants are available in our world, right? Not in our, only in our country, but also in our world, right? There are different types of plant. For example, tree, shrub, herbs, climber, creepers. So we are going to now differentiate about trees, herbs, shrubs, climbers and the creepers, what they are and how they are different from each other, right? So students, so let's start. And yes, in you can see teacher's health box. Students, some of facts and some things which is very unique is given in our book. Please always read these facts, read these some small topics, because these are valuable for us. Okay, like whenever our mother or father gives some suggestion to us, that is value for us. So these kind of books having their values. In short, you can say short note. So you should every time read it. Okay, let's do this. Discuss the importance of plant. Ask student to list 5 ways which plant help us. Okay, so by this method you can discuss about the importance of plant, right? And yes, you can also discuss the varieties of plant whichever you have seen in your daily lives, and if you are using it, you can share with me. Okay students, now I'm on page number 58. On the page number 57, you can underline the word like essential, numerous, climbers, creepers. So this kind of words are somehow difficult for you. That's why I'm just underlining you, so it will become your hard words. Okay, so students, types of plant. Now, as I said, we are going to learn about some different kinds of plant, various kinds of plant. So these are the part. Okay. So as we are starting our trees, right? As I said, human beings, right? Some human beings are thin. Some human beings are fit. Some human beings are healthy. Some are very thin. Some are strong, some are weak, you know, these kind of things we use to differentiate the human's body. So, as the same we use in plants also. How? We can see a tree. A tree is like a, you know, a strong plant, right? They live long and they grow day by day. You can see us, when we seed up something, okay. So by growth of this, you can see they become a plant with thick thorns called trees in your book. For example, neem and mangoes, they have many branches, okay? They having a long life span, which means they live long life. There are so many, you know, so many trees are there. They having long life span. There are some trees are which are living from 1,000 years from the 1,000 years, you know, they having their you all are 13 or 14, 10 or 12, okay. So these kind of trees having their their years like 1,000 years, they exist, okay. So these are trees, those having a long lifeline, okay. So those are tree, those are big, those are heavy, those having trunks, they having branches, right? They known as tree. Okay, I can show you a picture. This is given in your picture or in your surrounding. You can see the type of this kind of tree, right? Mango, neem, these are a heavy one. These having a lifelong span, okay, lifelong process, okay. So shrubs. Now shrubs plants are smaller than tree and have thin body stems called shrubs. Have you seen ever the rose? Have you seen tulsi? Right? So these kind of plants known as shrubs. Why? They are plant, but they are not as tree. They not grow as tree. Right? Tree having their long body with the long branches have a different type of variety, but in the shrubs they are small and they are thin, okay. So you can see here plants that are smaller than tree have thin and woody stems are called shrubs. For examples, they having their stems like trees. The trees having also stem of wood, and they also having a stem of wood, but that one is heavy. That means they are fat from than the shrubs, okay, and shrubs are thin than the trees. So you can see here, then for example, they given us the example of rose and jasmine. So they live for a shorter span of time. As the tree are big and heavy, they having a long span of time. But when we come to shrubs, they are they having short term life, right, than the tree, okay. So if you having your practical notebook, that means one page is blank to you, that is white, and the second one is the liner one, okay. So students, you should make up pictures of plant. Please do that, okay, because you having varieties of plants, herb, shrub, and these kind of plants. So you can make or you can draw some kind of pictures and you can show these are trees, these are shrubs, these are herbs, and these are creepers, right? So let's do the herbs. Now, plants with soft stems are called herbs. For example, mint and oregano. The leaves, flowers, and seed, these plants are used to make medicine and adds flavors to food. Okay, so these kind of plants, they don't have a woody stem like shrubs, but they having a soft stem, okay. So these are small plants. In daily life we are using it, right? Our mummy is using dhania, that is also a herb. And if you are using mint, pudina, that is also a part of our daily life. Okay. So some of them, some kind of herbs are used to make the medicines. Okay. Which means they are also very useful in the medicine. And yes, the second one is they are adding flavors to our food also. So herbs are different than the sherbs. Okay. Now there is climbers. Okay. Climbers plants with thin, soft, green stems are called climbers. For example, money plants, grapevine, and they climb on the wall stick on rows of spore. So this kind of plants having the same as they having leaves, they having stem, but they don't have they are disabled from the shrubs and trees and herbs. They don't have their own power to stand, right? They don't power to have to grow in a upper manner, right? They can't grow up. So what they do, they take a support of walls and the wooden stick so they can grow. You can see the examples of grapevine, which means in Hindi I can explain you angur. Angur jo hote hain wo aise hi lakdiyon ka sahara lekar badhte hain as they grow with the support of wooden sticks. Okay, but they are very tasty, right? I love it also. You should also love it if you don't. And then the second example is given as money plant. Money plants are usually we can see in every houses, right? They are very, they look very good. That's why the people are taking them as decoration of their houses. So but these kind of plants, they don't have their own spore. They take spores of others and then they grow. Okay. So they climb on the walls, sticks or rocks for the sport. That's why they are climbers. Okay. Knowing is fun. As I said, some space is given to us. Some topic is given to us in our book. So we should learn it. We should read it. Why? Because they give us extra knowledge. They explore something more for us. So as the growth of a plant depends on many factors, including soil and the climate. So if you remember, in our previous chapter we learned that how the plants grow. They grow with the help of sunlight, water, air, right? They make their food by these things. So the growth of a plant depends on many factors, including soil and climate. Apples are usually cultivated in states like Kashmir and Himachal. That means they have a special qualities. They can only grow in a special climate or special soil. So usually we can see the apples only grow in the Himachal, okay, in the Kashmir. So we can only found the apples in the Kashmir and Himachal. Why? Because these regions are very cold areas. So these kind of plants can grow in the cool areas, right? Now bananas are usually cultivated in state like Karnataka and Maharashtra. Why? They having a some kind of soil or a climate which can bananas can enjoy their growth, right, in this region. So they are the usually cultivated the bananas in Karnataka and the Maharashtra. So in the third one, mangoes are usually cultivated in Uttar Pradesh. Right, mangoes are usually cultivated in the Uttar Pradesh. Hope you know this. This is your state. If you don't know about your state, explore it. Right, when you explore about your state, if anyone asks you any question about your state, you can speak. You can tell them that in our city, so many things are you can visit. Right, so many places are there. So many knowledgeable things are there. So by this, you can explore your state. As I explored that UP, which means Uttar Pradesh, is full of they cultivated the mangoes, and parts of Bihar and West Bengal. So So the state, the three states are given for us to cultivate the mangoes, which are Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and West Bengal. So student, so 57 and 58, page number we have done this, right? You can, from the page number 58, you can only underline the medicines from the herbs, okay? Herbs paragraph. So as we have done the two pages of reading for today, hope you are learning yourself, okay? You are exploring yourself at your home. Please students, be serious, taking your class seriously, be active, be smart, okay? And yes, I can show you more things that how the plants are usable for us, but in the next video. So please watch it, and if you have any queries, then please comment it, right? Thank you, students.